वेलकम फ्रेंड, अगेन वी हैव टू डिस्कस आवर सब्जेक्ट कैलकुलस फर्स्ट। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस सम एग्जाम्पल ऑन लिमिट ऑफ अ सीक्वेंस। इन द टुडेज लेक्चर वी हैव टू डिस्कस सम थ्योरम्स ऑन the limit of the sequence. So today's our topic is limit theorems on limit or limit theorems. We can write our topic is limit theorem. Before going for the limit theorem, we have to define one definition of a bounded sequence. Bounded sequence. Already you know the concept of bounded. Suppose we take a set of natural number. This is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Is it bounded? It is not bounded. It is not bounded. Why it is not bounded? The set is bounded if it is bounded above and bounded below. This set is bounded below, but this set is not a bounded above. Therefore, this set of natural number is not a bounded set. Suppose we take interval 1, 2, 2, which is subset of a real number R. Now, this I is bounded or not? I is bounded? Yes, it is a bounded set. Why it is? Because it is bounded below and it is also bounded above. Therefore, we can say that this set is bounded. So, set is bounded if what we can say that it is bounded below and it is bounded above. The set of natural number is not a bounded, the interval 1, 2 is a bounded. Similar concept we have to discuss for the sequence. So we have to discuss the bounded sequence. So first we write the definition of bounded sequence. Let x is equal to xn be a sequence of a real number. Be a sequence of real numbers, then the sequence x is bounded if there exists a real number m greater than 0, such that what we can say that mod of xn is less than m, less than or equal to n for all n belongs to the natural number. Okay, so what we write the definition, let x is equal to xn be the sequence of real number, then the sequence is bounded if there exists a real number m greater than 0 such that mod of xn is less than or equal to m for all n belongs to the natural number. You think or rewind the definition of limit. This is similar, but here is not epsilon. Here is, instead of k we are taking here m, and here k, n is greater than or equal to k, but we are writing this bounded sequence is for all n belongs to the natural number. So you can correlate with the limit definition, then it is easy to keep in mind. Okay, so what we can say, sequence is a function. So we can write this, it is term in the terms of sequence also. That is the function definition also. So when the function is bounded, function is bounded if, what we can say that, if its image set is bounded. If its image set is bounded, similarly we can write here, thus we say that the sequence x is equal to xn is bounded if the set, which set, that is the image set xn, all n belongs to the natural number, is bounded. That is, we are written it is in terms of bounded function, because sequence is a function from natural number to the set. Okay, so we say that the sequence is bounded if the image set is bounded. Getting this? Okay, so what we see, bounded sequence. Suppose we take a example. What we take example, suppose our x is equal to xn, and xn we are writing, it is where xn is equal to minus 1 Richterian. Then can you say that this sequence is bounded? The first five terms of sequence are. So can you write first five terms? N is equal to 1, then this will be minus 1, n is equal to 2, 1, n is equal to 3, it is again minus 1, n is equal to 4, then it is 1, n is equal to, then what we can write, n is equal to 5, then it is again minus 1. Similarly, you can write all the terms. Then what we can see that this set, what we can say that the, then the set, what set? All xn such that n belongs to the natural number. What is it? This is the only two numbers, that is minus 1 and 1. This set is bounded. Hence we say that, hence the sequence x is equal to minus 1 raised to n, where n belongs to the natural number, is bounded. Okay, in the same way you can write, or you can take so many examples of a bounded sequence. So getting this? Now we have to go further, some theorems on the limit of the sequence. So first theorem, every convergent sequence is bounded. So this is important theorem. What is this? Every convergent sequence is a bounded. So can you write the proof? So we will write the proof of this. So every convergent sequence, for this we need one sequence, and we take x is equal to xn is a sequence of a real number which converges to x. Okay, so what we can say, let x is equal to xn be a sequence of a real numbers converges to the real number x. Suppose we are taking the x is equal to xn be a sequence of real number, and this sequence is converges to x. Okay, what we have to show, what we have to prove, the sequence x is equal to xn is bounded. Is it? The sequence x is equal to xn is bounded. That means what is the bounded sequence definition? What is this bounded sequence definition? There exists m greater than 0 such that what? Mod of xn is less than or equal to m for all n belongs to the natural number. That is, just we take the definition of a bounded sequence, just we have written this. Okay, so what is given? Given is sequence is bounded. And what we have to prove? There exists a m greater than 0 such that mod of xn is less than or equal to m for all n belongs to the natural number. Is it? So what is given? Given is the sequence x is equal to xn converges to x. So can you write the definition? Converges to x means what? Limit of the sequence is x. That is, what it implies? The limit of sequence x is equal to xn is x. And therefore, by definition, what we can write? For epsilon is equal to 1 greater than 0, there exists a natural number k. There exists a natural number k. We have written it is in the symbolic form. K belongs to the n such that mod of xn minus ax is less than epsilon, which is equal to 1 for all n is greater than or equal to k. Just we write the definition of a convergent sequence. Okay, so for every epsilon, or where we are taking epsilon is equal to 1, there exists a natural number k such that mod of xn minus x is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equal to k. Take n is greater than or equal to k and use triangle inequality. You know the triangle inequality, mod of x plus y is less than or equal to mod x plus mod y. So what we consider, we have to show that mod of xn is less than or equal to m. And for this, what we can do? We take mod of xn, add and subtract x, so mod of xn minus x plus x, and now use the triangle inequality for this. So what we are getting? Mod of xn minus x plus x mod x, and this is strictly less than, by star, it is less than what? It is less than 1. It is less than 1 plus mod x. 1 plus mod x. This is by star. Okay? So what we did? We just add and subtract x and use the triangle inequality, and then we are using what? Star. So we get this. Now what we have to take? We have to find m. So what we take? M is equal to supremum of this inequality is holds for what? N is greater than or equal to k. So which terms are remaining here? Mod x1, mod x2, and so on, mod xk minus 1, and this one, 1 plus mod x. So what we take? M is the supremum of all these numbers. Then there exist m greater than 0 such that what we can write? Mod of xn is less than or equal to what? M for all n belongs to the natural number. This inequality holds for n is greater than or equal to k, but we take all the m is the maximum of all these numbers, and therefore this inequality holds for all n belongs to the natural number. Okay? This is the definition of a bounded sequence. Therefore, the sequence x is equal to xn is bounded. And there, thus what we are getting, every convergent sequence is bounded. So this is again a very simple and important proof. So what is the basic is the definition of a convergent sequence, that is the limit of the sequence, is it? So if you get clear definition, then you can prove any theorem. For this you need to do the practice. So getting this, so we will go for the next theorem. So we will go for the next theorem, that is, let limit x is equal to xn and y is equal to yn be the sequences of a real numbers that converges to x and y respectively. That means the sequence xn converges to x and yn converges to y. Then our first claim, that is what first we have to prove, the sequence x plus y converges to the x plus y. And the sequence x minus y converges to the x minus y. So we will prove first. Okay. So what we have given or what we have to prove? We have to prove the sequence x plus y is equal to xn plus yn converges to x plus y. That is what we have to prove. The sequence has a limit, that is, limit x plus y or xn plus yn is equal to x plus y. And what it means, that definition of limit, that is nothing but what we can say here, you can write limit x or n tends to infinity. Okay, if you are not written it also, or every epsilon greater than 0 there exists a natural number k belongs to the n such that what we can write, mod of what, xn plus yn minus x plus y is less than epsilon for all, what we can say, for all n is greater than or equal to k. This is we have to prove. So for this, what is given what, the sequence x is equal to xn and y is equal to yn. Y is equal to yn converges just to x and y respectively. Okay. Therefore, what we can say, that for every epsilon greater than 0 there exist k1 and k2 natural number such that what we can write, k1 for xn and k2 for yn. So what we can write, mod of xn minus ax is less than epsilon by 2. We are taking here epsilon by 2 for all n is greater than or equal to k1, and both definition we are written, it is one sentence. So yn minus y is less than epsilon by 2 for all n is greater than or equal to k2. Now what we have to take, we have to say this k is equal to supremum of k1 and k2. Therefore what we can say, this definition holds for both k. So what we can take, consider consider k is greater, or what we can say, n is greater than or equal to k mod of xn plus yn minus x plus y. How we write this? Just write, it is in the simplified form, xn minus x plus yn minus y. Now use what we have to use here, triangle inequality. So what is triangle inequality? Triangle inequality. What is triangle inequality? It is mod of x plus y is less than or equal to mod x plus mod y. So here what we can write, it is less than or equal to mod of xn plus minus x plus mod of yn minus y. Is it? Mod of yn minus y. And what we can write therefore, and now by say this is what? This is our star, suppose. So by using star, what we can write, this is strictly less than epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2, which is equal to epsilon by using star. That is, therefore, what we are getting? Therefore, mod of xn plus yn minus x plus y is less than, it is less than what? Epsilon for all n is greater than or equal to k. And what we have? Since epsilon is greater than 0, is arbitrary, it is arbitrary, the sequence x plus y, that is xn plus yn, converges to what? X plus y. This is very simple. We have to take just epsilon by 2 instead of epsilon here. Why it is? Because we need this term is less than epsilon. Is it? Getting this? So what we did here, if the xn and yn are the two sequences converges to x and y, then their sum is converges to their limit. Their sum converges to their limit. In the similar way, we have to prove the sequence x minus y converges to the x minus y, limit x minus y. Is it? This you can do for a homework. You have to do, it is for a homework. How you can do this? Just I am giving idea. Again you have to write same. Here is what? Minus. Here is what? Minus. Then what you can write? Here minus. Then here is minus. Then just you have to take here negative. Here is minus. Similar way you have to write the definition. Here minus. Here minus. Then just you have to change here. From this you have to change. Here. Is it? Just do simplification again, use the triangle inequality corollary, you will get the answer. Okay, just you have to change the sign in the same proof. Okay, so you can write this for homework. So what we see in today's lecture, we see bounded definition of a bounded sequence, then we take one theorem. That is the every convergent sequence is bounded. It is important theorem. And we take one theorem. That is the if two sequences are there, then the addition of these two sequences is again converges to the sum of the limits of the sequences. Okay? So, do practice for this. We will stop here. Thank you very much.